What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Tay TV and my reaction video for today. I will be reacting to the biggest and scariest insects in the world. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel and follow me. My social media is below. Let's get straight into this video.
A week. Millions of years ago, gigantic insects roamed the earth. However, modern ones have grown to be so small because of the limited size of the insect's hair pipe. Despite the miniature size we know most insects for, others grow beyond our expectations. These 10 insects are the biggest and scariest on the planet.
Okay, so these 10 insects are the biggest and scariest on the planet.
Hercules beetle. The Hercules beetle is named after the famous Greek hero Hercules. This insect lives in the rainforests of South America, Central America, and the Caribbean islands. Its most prominent feature is the horn-like appendage that extends from its thorax and another that protrudes from the head. Females don't have horns. A male Hercules beetle measures 7 inches long due to the horns, as this extra body part makes up half of its entire body length. Scientists have difficulty comparing this creature to other types of insects because of the extra large horns. The Hercules beetle spends most of its time in larva. It remains in larva until after 2 years. Thus, larvae can grow up to 4.5 inches long and weigh over 3.5 ounces. They're an excellent source of protein when consumed. This insect mates in the rainy season, and males fight to mate with females using their horns. The winner pushes the loser away off a tree limb and takes home the prize. While this beetle isn't the largest in the world, it deserves mention. Titan beetle. Measuring about 6.5 inches long, the titan beetle is endemic to the Amazon rainforest. Although smaller than the Hercules beetle, this insect has a bigger body. Some scientists argue they're bigger because they don't have any horns, yet keep the same size as the animal with horns. When threatened, this beetle makes a hissing sound and tries to defend itself. Their large mandibles and firm jaw give them a powerful biting force capable of piercing human skin.
Wow.
Scientists have observed their larvae and conclude
human skin.
That they can grow to 1 foot. This larva gathers energy that would benefit the beetle in the future. This species is so large that it can't take off from the ground. It must first perch on a tree before flying. This beetle feeds on decaying wood below the ground. Although large, they don't eat much, but spend most of their time reproducing. They like to get busy.
They only reproduce. They like to get busy.
Don't pose any threat
okay.
To the ecosystem. It's not advisable to get rid of them. Stick insect.
Stick insect. I never heard of that.
Also called a walking stick, ghost insect, or leaf insect, the stick insect is a vast order of insects that comprises around 3,000 species. Nearly all are characterized by a flat, spindly, and tube-like appearance. This insect has evolved a unique ability to hide from predators by blending in with tree branches they resemble. Some other species wield mossy outgrowth or lichen to make their camouflage look more convincing. Of all the insects in the world that resemble a stick, this one is the largest. Like most creatures, stick insects have an interesting defense mechanism against predators. They can lose a leg to escape predators and regenerate it after they're safe.
They can lose a leg to escape predators and then lose their leg when they're safe. Wow, that's dope.
If it fails, they resort to playing dead. They fall off from where they're perching and play dead for some minutes until they're out of the danger zone. This means that the attacker loses interest seeing they're motionless. Most stick insects measure at least 1 foot long. The longest ever discovered was in China, reaching a whopping 25 inches long. The others were about 22 inches. Despite this extraordinary length, they do weigh much.
Goliath beetles.
You don't need much explanation to get a mental picture of this insect. The Goliath beetle is a species that inhabits the tropical rainforests of Africa. Their most prominent physical characteristics are the unusual markings on their back.
Okay.
They measure 3 to 4.5 inches long. They're heavier than most of their counterparts. An adult Goliath beetle weighs over 2 ounces, which is heavy for an insect. In their larval stage, they weigh as much as 3.5 ounces and are almost 10 inches long in adulthood. Goliath beetles have claws that allow them to climb trees. Their outer wing, called the elytra, protects the softer pair of exposed wings.
Okay.
Although the inner wings are soft, They're used for flying and can carry loads of up to 850 times their weight.
The 850 times their weight.
Sugar, which includes tree sap and rotten fruit. Juveniles prefer protein, so they eat dung, plant matter, and animal remains. Their feeding choice helps the ecosystem because they remove excess animal and plant matter from the environment.
Was enchanting, completely captivating on so many different levels.
From the beginning.
Moth. Moths make it to this list thanks to their wingspan. While there are several species, the Atlas moth is the most impressive. It lives in the tropical forests of the shrublands in Asia, and is the largest of its kind. Its wingspan
measures
11 inches. Plus a wing surface of 25 square inches.
Ooh, 25 square inches, I got that.
Moth, Atticus Caesar, and White Witch come close. The Atlas moth's body is small compared to the orange and white wings resembling swirling jewels. This moth has some incredible defense strategies. As caterpillars, they spray strong-smelling secretions to protect themselves from predators. Since the tip of an adult moth resembles a snakehead, it uses it to its advantage. Scientists believe they use it to scare predators. Females
attract smart males tactic.
By releasing powerful pheromones. She doesn't move far from this location, but hangs around where the air currents will carry her wonderful pheromones. Giant Weta.
Giant Weta.
The Weta is also nicknamed the God of Ugly Things.
The God of
it's
Ugly Things.
It's endemic to New Zealand and the surrounding offshore island. These flightless crickets grow to 4 inches long and weigh nearly 2.5 ounces. Scientists say there are 11 recognized giant weta species living in shrubs and trees. However, they come to the ground for mating. When threatened, they defend themselves using their sharp, spiny legs.
Their
Since
legs.
New Zealand didn't have any mammalian species
quick.
Before humans arrived,
Look at
researchers
that.
Believed wetas evolved to occupy the same niche as rodents. After introducing real rodents to the ecosystem, these crickets saw a steady population decline. Today, they're protected by the government and have slightly recovered, but they still face countless challenges. Female giant wetas carry as many as 200 to 300 eggs in their lifetime. They lay these eggs using a female organ called an ovipositor. These eggs come out resembling adults, but become full-blown adults after 2 years. Researchers say this insect lives for 6 to 9 months after adulthood. Butterflies.
Butterflies.
Butterflies also deserve a spot on this list.
Okay, they deserve a spot on the
especially
list.
Especially the Jamaican swallowtail, Ripon's birdwing, Miranda birdwing, and Queen Alexandra's birdwing. Of all the species, Queen Alexandra's birdwing takes the prize for the largest butterfly. It's named after Queen Alexandra, the wife of King Edward VII of Britain. This creature lives in New Guinea and exhibits a significant degree of sexual dimorphism. Meaning that both sexes are distinct. Females
both sexes
are, the larger
are distinct,
of the two,
okay.
With their body sizes reaching up to 3 inches long and a wingspan of 11 inches. They also have brown wings and white markings arranged in two rows near the tips. Males have thinner wings measuring 6 to 8 inches from tip to top. During mating season, males hover over females and shower them with pheromones to induce copulation. Studies show that females don't accept mates until they fly over the forest trees. Scientists are uncertain why this happens. Females eventually lay up to 240 eggs in their lifetime, but carry 15 to 30 eggs at once. And to our best pick.
Best pick of the video.
British entomologist Francis Walker first described this grasshopper species in 1870. Since then, scientists have had fun exploring them. Hedge grasshopper.
Hedge grasshopper.
The hedge grasshopper is the largest grasshopper species in the world. It's found in Australia, particularly in tropical and subtropical regions. Females measure nearly 3 inches, but some have been known to surpass this figure. Males are smaller and only reach about 2.15 inches. They have a wide range of colors and markings, with green or gray on their bodies. Hedge grasshoppers are solitary and don't form swarms. Therefore, they're not dangerous to plants. This insect's life cycle is adjusted based on their eggs are deposited in early summer and measure between 5 to 6 millimeters. For overposition, females drill a cylinder-shaped duct into the wet soil. The clutch is then deposited at the bottom of the duct with up to 150 eggs. The initial 5-millimeter-long nymphs hatch and leave the duct within the next heavy rainfall. One interesting fact about this grasshopper is that males create music with their legs by crossing
them in front of their wings. They create music with their legs. Wow, never heard of that before.
While there are over 500 species of hedge grasshoppers, only a few are a nuisance to crops. Tarantula hawks. The tarantula hawk belongs to a group of spider wasp species. They're named after tarantulas because they tend to consume the creature. The wasp starts by immobilizing the spider with its sting and bringing the meal into its nest, where a newly hatched larva consumes it whole. After adulthood, the tarantula hawk reaches 2.7 inches long, with a wingspan of 4.5 inches. If a human is unlucky enough to be attacked by this insect, the result is excruciating pain. Thankfully, this sting doesn't require serious medical attention, but you may want to see a doctor if it triggers an allergic reaction. This insect has been named second place on the Schmidt Sting Pain Index, with the first being the South American bullet ant. The pain from the bullet ant lasts 24 hours, but this hawk's pain doesn't last as far as the whole day. Adult tarantula hawks feed on nectar, but females prefer to battle spiders for food. This insect is often docile unless provoked or threatened. Their main defense is sting, as their legs are covered in sharp spines that act as a defensive armor.
Before we move on, I've got a little challenge for you that'll take 5 seconds to complete. So here's the deal. You just leave a like on this video, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell, and you'll get 25 years of amazing luck. Try it. It really works.
Midas flies.
Midas flies.
The Midas is a large fly with over 500 species, most of whom are endemic to arid or semi-arid regions of the world. They're dangerous to humans in warm and tropical regions. Some species have evolved the ability to mimic dangerous stinging bees and wasps. This helps them trick predators into avoiding them. Farmers love Midas flies because they're considered a natural form of pest control. Their larva laid near decaying matter feeds on other grubs, thereby preventing the threat they pose to cultivated plants. Despite their size, they're agile while flying. Not only do they feed on flies, but they also love to satisfy their sweet tooth by drinking nectar. These insects rub their legs together to stay clean. The bristles on the legs are sensory organs that help them taste the food they land on. The largest known Midas fly species is called Quaromidas heuros, and measures 2.8 inches long with a wingspan of 3.9 inches, making it the largest fly on the planet.
This is it for this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Follow me on my social medias below. Stay tuned for my next reaction video. Thank you.